The energy transition is at the heart of our European Green Deal.
Reducing the cost of energy can be done and at the same time decarbonizing their energy resources as well.
Renewables are key, but still, solar and wind energy are a variable source. And the electricity grid only reaches about one quarter of the global population. Here, generators and cogeneration, short CHP, plants step in.
Generators are needed if the power is not there, or if there's not enough power, we need a generator. Or if we need heat and power at the same time in big quantities. There are many companies who have emergency generators, also companies who use a lot of electricity, like data centers.
Right now, 80% of the combined heat and electricity plants run on natural gas and fossil fuels. So those options are not really sustainable.
We are looking for a climate neutral energy provision. The last years, there's a lot of development in wind and solar. But wind and solar are fluctuating, it's not always there. So we need to balance the grid. We need some alternatives, we need dispatchable power. And biomass is a good solution for that. But using solid biomass is not that easy. So we started already a long time ago working on using pyrolysis oil in an engine. It's a nice liquid.
The basis for the fast pyrolysis oil is solid non-food biomass from agricultural residues and organic waste. But can this oil be used in traditional generator engines?
Normally, these engines, they use diesel-like fuels and they have very specific, a very narrow band of properties. And pyrolysis oil is quite different. So what we try to do here is how well does it compare? Where are we? Is it more like a gasoline or more like a diesel? We're really looking into the details of the combustion properties for which we can really compare it against all kinds of other fuels.
In fact, the fast pyrolysis bio oil has a higher water content and a lower heating value compared to fossil fuels, which affects its willingness to combust.
Pyrolysis oil as such cannot be used directly in a diesel engine. It will corrode the system. So we had to make the modification. And that's the main challenge of this project, is to develop a new fuel injection system. And that's it's the injector itself with the small holes on top. It's 200 micron holes. We had to replace this material. And we also integrated the fuel pump within the fuel injection system. And that's really the new development here.
The SmartCHP project develops a retrofit package for a standard diesel engine. Combined with a smart control unit, the system is fully responsive to changes in heat and power demand.
When we run the engine on fast pyrolysis oil, the performance is very similar to normal diesel. So we have a similar efficiency, same performance, and we will add a flue gas treatment also to guarantee very low emissions at all the times. The only difference is that we are using a sustainable fuel.
In the end, the SmartCHP project will provide small-scale biomass-based cogeneration plants, which will significantly contribute to make the energy system clean, flexible, secure and efficient.
To my opinion, if we don't use this, we will have a hard time getting to what we need to, the 30 and 50% reductions in our carbon footprint. And that is why I think it's not an interim solution, it's a solution for the future.